like music, eh? Maybe you should go to work in a phonograph store. Or maybe I should rent a 20-piece orchestra. Look at that work piling up while you play with the hoity-goity.
I'll catch up, Mr. Gert.
You bet you will if you have to work all night. And that goes for the rest of you girls, too. I got work to get out. How can I get it out with somebody popping up behind my back all the time? Popping here, popping there, popping out to get a drink of water, then popping out to... What do you think I'm running here, a coffee clutch? Now bear down on them machines.
What do you think I'm running here? Coffee clutch or something, huh? How can I get the work out with you girls popping up and down all the time? Popping up for this and popping up for that and popping up for the hoity-goity. Now bear down on the machines.
Ah, the sewing machine, a girl's best friend. If I didn't have my sewing machine, I'd have come to no good end. But I'm bobbin', I'm bobbin' and pedal, a pedal and wheel, the wheel by day. So by night, I feel so weary that I never get out to play. Oh, the sewing machine, a friend in need. If I didn't have my sewing machine, a wicked life I'd lead. But a bobbin' and pedal, a pedal and dream about romance. So by night, I feel so weary that I never get out to dance. The sewing machine, my pride and joy. If I didn't have my sewing machine, I'd have married James McCoy. But I bobbin' a bobbin' and pedal a pedal, and that's the end of Jim. 'Cause by night I get so weary, I don't even look good to him. A boss, he looks like a horse, his name's Joe Goyt. I'm willing to bet the wages I get that face of his must hoit. While I'm bobbin' and pedal a pedal, he keeps his eyes on me. Oh, I've never had a nightmare where I didn't meet Mr. G.
So, you think I was talking to my half, huh? Just for that, you're all Dr. Half-Day's pay. How do you like that?
Oh, look, Mr. Gert, don't take it out on those girls. It was all my fault. And I'm sorry. Honest, I am.
You're sorry, huh? Mr. Goyt, his face must hoit. Nightmares you're having, that's funny.
Oh, I was only clowning. Well, I think you're swell. Oh, come on, be a nice guy. Those kids need the dough. You wouldn't really dock them, would you?
Well, that all
depends on what?
Oh, on your being nice to me.
Oh, I'm always nice to you, Mr. Gert.
Joe's the name.
Joe. Lay off me, you big apron. I'll knock your teeth out. Oh.
Bravo, child. Well done. You very definitely have a way with you, my dear.
A girl's best friend is a good looping right.
Very effective, too, my child.
Oh, Miss Gibbs, I must have had one of my dizzy spells.
When I was her age, lots of chaps got dizzy spells. With me, it was the left. My costume, please. I'm in a hurry. Come.
Oh, gosh, Miss Gibbs. I remember seeing you in Thundercloud. I seen it twice. Gee, will you drink that poison? You sure do die elegant.
Thank you, child. You flatter me.
Oh, it ain't only you. It's anybody in show business. Well, I think they're the most wonderful people there is.
Then I take it you like the theater.
Like it? Oh, gosh, Miss Gibbs, if I could only be on a stage, why... Just to think about it makes me sick at my stomach.
Child.
Here it is. Ah. $98.
Very reasonable. My secretary will send you a check.
Gotham Costumes is strictly for cash.
But my...
Get her on the phone, she brings down the cash, and the garment is yours.
Impossible. We open in Danbury tonight. I'm on my way to the train now.
Foyle, put it back in stock.
Oh, gee.
Wait. Have this child come to the station with me. I'm meeting my secretary there. She'll give her a check.
She'll give her the cash.
You collar thing, Scrooge. Are you insinuating I'm a deadbeat?
I ain't insinuating nothing, just no checks.
Very well. You shall have your paltry pennies. And now, you greedy, impolite lout, open the door for a lady.
Get going, and if you give her the costume without the cash, you're stuck for it.
Farrington! Farrington! I can't stand for any further delay. In another 5 minutes, they'll be tearing my theater apart. Where is this kid?
I don't know, but we'll open anyway.
Open? Come on, hurry up. Open? Open with what? Who's going to play Lady Capulet?
He is.
Under protest.
Breathe in.
Farrington, you're crazy, I tell you.
Go away. Go, Bob. Please.
Farrington, this is an outrage.
It's our only chance. Now, hurry up.
No! Wind. Too tight! I can't breathe.
Too tight! The mustache!
Oh, no, not my mustache!
Oh,
no!
Oh, yeah! Yes.
No, no! Farrington, I quit! I resign.
Raise it.
No, no.
Greetings, fellow lesbians.
Oh, I ought to greet you with a good swift kick. Where have you been? I ought to hang you in front of the theater.
Quiet,
with your own...
Irish clown. We've a bit of a problem here.
Listen to that audience. Get into your costume.
I said we've a bit of a problem. Miss White. Mr. Farrington.
Hello.
Hello. Don't stand there. Get dressed.
I promised Miss White an audition.
You what?
She has great talent. She also has my costumes.
Yes, for 98 bucks.
98?
Cash.
Well, if Miss Gibbs promised you an audition, you have come at a most opportune moment.
Gee, Mr. Farrington,
not a word, not a word. Oh, not at all, my dear, not at all. Oh, don't thank me, it's no trouble. The Farrington players always keep a pact. We have the costumes.
Hey, but what about the 98?
You have the audition. And an audience to boot.
Oh, but they'll murder me.
You want to be an actress, don't you?
Oh, but I never did.
You'll have to learn to face all kinds of audience.
Hi, folks. I ain't part of the regular show. I'm just a little something extra to get things set back there. And it's mighty important that I get it. All I want to do is sing a little song for you.
I am back to the beanery.
Shut up. If I'm any good, give me a little hand. If I ain't, you can break up the seats and toss them at me, and I promise I'll toss them back. Okay?
Hey, do you know Rumble?
Yeah, number 16, boys. What key?
I don't know, just so it ain't too high.
I gotta move. I gotta move. That's what I tell my landlord. Landlord? I gotta move. 'Cause there's a man lives right upstairs from me, making a nightmare of the melody. This is a situation not likely to improve. He goes a rumble, rumble, rumble on the left hand. He goes a tinkle, tinkle, tinkle on the right. Rumble, 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 tinkle, 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 plays piano all night. He goes a rumble, rumble, rumble on the bottom. He goes a tinkle, tinkle, tinkle on the top. Rumble, 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 tinkle, 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 positively won't stop. I got a knock, a knock, knocking on the ceiling. I got a knocking, knocking, knocking on the wall. He takes a breather. No, he doesn't either. Just when I figure that's all. He goes a rumble, rumble, rumble on the black keys. He goes a tinkle, tinkle, tinkle on the wire. Rumble, 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 tinkle, tinkle, tinkle. Plays piano all right. But he plays piano all night. Instead of cooking himself a quiet kettle of tea up there, or maybe getting himself a girl and taking her out somewhere, instead of sitting around reading the jokes, washing his socks, writing his folks, taking a pill, sleeping the night through, what does he do? What does he do? He goes a rumble, rumble, rumble. Look at the whole building crumble. Tinkle, tinkle, tinkle. Look at the wallpaper wrinkle. Rumble, rumble, rumble. Tinkle, tinkle, tinkle. He could give his zombie a to rip and winkle with that rumble, rumble, rumble. I've got a good right to grumble. Tinkle, tinkle, tinkle. I'm gonna raise quite a stop. With his left hand, he goes grub, grub, grub with his right. A fumbly, grub, a fumbly, grub, a fumbly, grub, fumble till he gets it right. Then he plays piano all
night. Hey, she's all right. Ideal curtain raiser for Shakespeare. That's it up. Places, everybody. House lights, curtain.
Mr. Farrington. Do I get a job?
Shh. Yes.
What about the 98 bucks?
I should be very happy to take it out of your salary.
Oh, gee, thanks. That's swell. Huh? Oh, gosh, I'm so happy. I'm scared any minute now. I'm going to wake up.
Child, never forget this moment this happened. Not even when they've broken your heart and you're trying to put the pieces back together again. Promise me.
Oh, don't you worry about me. I'll be all right. I learn to take it as it comes.
I don't know. You have a brave heart, child. A brave heart, like all rare and very fine things, are easily broken.
You know, Miss Gibbs, having you for a friend is just about the most wonderful thing that ever happened to me.
Oh, child.
Congratulations, Miss Fite. I understand from Mr. Farrington that you're going to be one of us.
Oh, thanks. Gosh, Mr. Timmons, I guess this is something I've been wanting all my life.
Oh, that's nice.
Do you think I'll make it, Mr. Timmons? I mean, I can sing anyways. It ought to help some, huh?
Well, not exactly, Miss White. Not exactly. You see, in singing, the voice is inclined to run away with you. In acting, the basic factor is voice control. You must be its master and not it yours. You must control it completely. Any questions?
Yeah. What do you mean, control it?
Well, the voice is pitched to exactly the right volume, tuned to precisely the right tone, and projected. Sorry. Projected. Not just unloaded like a truckload of scrap iron. And how is the voice projected? With the lips? No. The esophagus? No. The lungs? No. The diaphragm? Yes. The diaphragm projects the voice from here, swelling, growing, rounding up to the lips and round like an orange. Always project to the rear of the theater. And remember, round like an orange. Oh! Not the pit.
entire orange, skin and all. Never enunciate like a lemon or a grape. Now, watch my lips carefully. Come, see the chrysanthemums budding. Note the enunciation. Chrysanthemums budding. Never a clip. Ing, 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 ing,
ing, ing, ing, ing, ing. Oh, Mr. Timmons was just showing me how to project my voice.
One of these days, I'm going to project Mr. Timmons out on his ear.
Mr. Farrington, that settles it. I quit.
White, I hope to make an actress out of you.
Oh, Mr. Farrington!
Sit down, please. To be an actress, Miss White, even a mediocre one, calls for hard work, back-breaking work, day and night. The theater demands the best you've got. I demand it. You must consider no job too big, no task too small.
I'll do anything. Honest, I will.
That's the spirit. Start you in with a little mending. He's got a bad rip here, tear in there someplace. Well, this is a bad one. These are out at the heel, I think, yeah. Need them for tomorrow's matinee. See you in the morning.
Carriage awaits. My lord, your carriage awaits. My lord, your carriage awaits. My
petticoat, please.
Yeah, it's over here. Here you are.
Thank you, dear.
How about my shirt?
Oh, it ain't dry yet.
I'll have to put it on wet.
My lord.
Hey, girl, you got my thingamajig?
Yeah. Hey, you better go easy on these. One more tool in your route.
Thanks.
My lord.
Where are my socks, Pearl?
Down the end of the line, Timmy. My lord, your carriage awaits. My lord, your carriage awaits.
No, no, no. More English. My lord, your carriage awaits.
Me lord, your carriage. Me lord, my lord, oh, heck.
Pearl! Hurry, child, you're on.
Oh, oh, wait. Me lord, my lord, my lord, your carriage awaits. Oh, I'm so scared.
There's nothing to be scared about. You'll be wonderful.
Oh, very clever, my lady. Your wit is surpassed only by your beauty. Come in.
My lord, your carriage awaits. Oh. Mr. Farrington, well, how'd I do?
You were dynamic, Miss White. Positively explosive. Your entrance was like a 21-gun salute.
My lord, your carriage awaits.
For the love of heaven, can't you keep your hands down?
Tonight?
Yes, you will, dear, you will.
But Lansford, you can't go on, you can't. You hurt bad.
I've got to go, honey. This message must go through.
Colonel Lansford, sir.
Yes, Magnolia.
Them dirty Yankees are coming around by the old mill. You all better get out of here, sir, before they catch us up with you. Rest of them got 60 seconds.
Magnolia.
Mr. Farrington, was I better?
Much better.
Oh, thanks, Mr. Farrington. Will you untie my hands now?
Look, Miss White. You're Maloa, a native princess. You've just battled through a typhoon to tell me that you love me. And you act like you're selling popcorn.
Sorry.
Hey, boys! Go out and have yourselves a beer on me. Give us a half hour of quiet. All right, let's take it again. Pick it up from, many times you say...
Many times you have said, I am very beautiful, Kanakakio. But your eyes, Kanakakio, they cannot look into my heart. So let your lips tell you what your eyes cannot see.
The kiss. You're supposed to kiss me. Lines, if you please. You do know the lines, don't you? Then say them. Or do we have to hire a prompter just for you? Now, what brought that on?
Idiot.
What's got into all the women around here?
It's spring. Never meant much to us, I know, but lots of people get quite emotional about it.
Oh, no. I am not interested in the flutterings of Miss White's emotions.
Could be if you gave yourself half a chance.
You just concentrate on your boots. It'll keep your simple mind from wandering. Miss White! Miss White! On stage! Completely objective about this, Miss White. You're going to play Maloa. You'll be kissing me several times a week. And emotion has nothing to do with it. If you're going to be an actress, you'll have to learn that the man you're kissing is no more than another prop on the stage. Like a tree, a door, or a wooden bench.
Yes, Mr. Farrington.
We'll begin with the last line.
Your eyes cannot see. Now you know, Kanakakio, more than if I spoke with words. Line is yours, Mr. Farrington.
What's the matter, Mike? They get your lines?
We'll continue rehearsals later.
I wish to warn you that the decent people of this island will no longer tolerate your disgraceful behavior.
Why don't you mind your own business?
Oh.
Turn around, Pearl.
I couldn't
my dear. Mr. Farrington is a stickler for realism.
Then I fall when it gets to the volcanic eruption. He'll send me on fire.
You drunken, shameless sot. I warn you, I shall go to the authorities.
Go on, you old biddy. Go away. Oh. Get out of here.
Oh.
Good luck.
I told you to go away, you old biddy. Now go away.
It is I, below.
You. Oh, why do you torture me with all your loveliness? Why do you come here? Oh, Maloa, Maloa.
Can it cook you? Can it cook you?
Well?
Can it cook?
Go on. Say it. You don't have to spare me. You won't be saying anything I don't already know. Say it. For the love of heaven, say it!
What's the matter with you?
Catch it cold. Get it cold.
Did you think of coming here would change anything between us? Or did you come to gloat over my despair? Well, you need an answer. I can see it in your eyes. Don't say a word!
Hacho!
Gesundheit!
Thank you.
We're lucky to be leaving town under our own power.
Coming through.
Hey, props. Better cover the name in that trunk. And I'd advise all you people to separate on your way to the depot. So if there's a mob with tar and feathers waiting, maybe some of us can get through.
Oh, Mike, what's done, done. Forget it.
Forget it? I'm willing. But will this town forget it? Why, every time the name of Farrington is mentioned, it'll be a belly laugh.
Well, what's wrong with that? The way we played it tonight, it was more fun for everybody. Even the audience.
I'm not running a burlicue.
Gesundheit.
Shut up!
Can I help it if I caught cold?
You could have picked a more opportune time.
And you shouldn't have turned them fans on me when I was all wet.
Wet or dry, you're a rotten actress. And it's not them fans, it's those fans. You can speak English, you know, even if it is through your nose.
Shut up, you ham!
Ham?
Yes, ham. If you're as good as you think you are, why ain't you on Broadway instead of hopping around from one whistle stop to the next, one jump ahead of the sheriff?
That's enough.
Okay, maybe I am a rotten actress, but I tried, didn't I? Gave it everything I had, didn't I? Simply you beat my brains out and drink me like something you scooped out of the gutter, and you know why? Because it came from you, because I thought you were something extra special. The real McCoy. Ain't that a wow? Why, you're nothing but a cheap, two-bit, bird-stirring four-flusher.
Where are you going, Pat?
Back to the sweatshop. There's a heel run, that joint, too. But in between being a heel, once in a while, here's a kind word for you.
Strange. When Pearl said those things, I found myself cheering. I don't think I'll be happy around here any longer, Mike. You see, it's a question of loyalty. And I'm too old to get them all mixed up.
Very well. I'm not going to ask you to stay, Julia. I never beg favors. I've never learned how.
You'll learn, my friend. You'll learn. It'll come to you as you go along.
So, my love for have faded long ago. I wish I didn't need your kiss. Why must your kiss torture me as long as this? Smiling by now with some new tender friend. Smiling by now with my heart on the mend. But when I try something in that heart says no.
Julia, you know how it is. Summertime, show business is dead.
Come back in September.
In September, we'll be dead.
Oh, now listen, Julia, you know I'd do anything for you. But I was, as I was saying, there's just no business in the summertime. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, this is Willie. Art Craft.
Come back and see us in a couple of months.
Oh, wait a minute, Julia.
Julia.
Yeah, I got one right here, if you'll play it. I can spot you in a grand damn part if you want it.
When did rehearsals start?
No, this ain't the legit, this is the flickers.
You know, moon pictures.
Yeah, maybe you got a run out of it, 3-4 days.
Those horrible things?
What's horrible about them? They don't know if it's winter or summer.
No, they eat all the time.
$5 a day lunch and car fare.
Lunch and car fare? She's in.
I'll send her right over.
Pearl, I will not.
We gotta eat, ain't we?
Haven't we?
Where do we go?
Come right along with me.
Would you... If you two ever mention this to anyone, you're through as my agent.
Oh, Sherry,
I don't know
Julia.
I'll tell you the scene.
So if you want to watch, stay back here.
Miss Gibbs, you're a Dutch, you see. Lots of class. You're mad at the helpie and you're going to fire him. Now, when I say, okay, Miss Gibbs, you'll hightail it in here through that door and just start bawling the pants off him. And then I'll cut. Okay?
But where are my lines?
Lines? Oh, you don't need no lines. Something will come to you.
Oh.
Boys, hang. She starts boiling you out, see? Then when I cue you, wham, let her have it. Smack them and kiss them. Look. I ain't tipped her off, see? We'll get a better take. All right, everybody. This is the take.
Places, everybody. Here we go.
Give it about 12.
Okay.
Camera. Action!
I'll do it.
Now, brush it up.
Of this disturbance. Pack your things and leave this house right now.
Now? Now!
Cut, Brennan. Get a sling.
Perfect, Gibbsy.
Oh, boy. They murdered him.
Struggle on a cliff. How can that villain be so awful? Me?
when she's in some desperate plight, and I'm about to die with fright. Zip goes the bill. Good night for Pauline.
Chain. But you just give me a can of film, and I can run it upside down and pack the house. That's Pearl Light going over Niagara Falls. Every time she does it, some jittery dame passes out cold. Hey, look it. You cut your act down to 5 minutes, and I'll use you as a filler while we change reels.
I'm not interested in fillers.
Me neither. I was just trying to do you a favor.
When I want charity, I'll come to you with a tin cup.
There. You see what I mean? Pearl White sure does lay him in the aisles. Yes, sir. I guess she's just about the biggest thing in pictures. Well, sorry I can't help you.
Here she comes. And don't forget, we got to get this on the first take. Won't be another train along for 5 hours. Think you can make it, honey?
Sure I can make it.
On Pearl's third shot, Slim and Pinky will take a flopper roll. And don't forget, fall in front of the camera. Let's go.
For a knife.
Come on, Timmy, hop out of there. I can use you. Now hurry up.
Thanks for everything, Annabelle. I have been looking forward to meeting you again with ketchup.
The harem of Yachapacha. See what no alien eye has ever seen before. Step inside, folks, and thrill to the sacred dance of the seven veils. All right, give them a sample, girl. Not too much and not too little. Step inside and see.
Mike,
are you a sight for sore eyes?
Easy, easy.
Oh, hey, you were doing all right for yourself.
Doesn't look like one night stand.
Uh-huh, big time now.
Yeah, what?
And my boss is interested in you.
Your boss? He
wants to talk to you, waiting on the pier. Go ahead, Mike.
Go ahead.
I'll take over.
Hey, come here, Mike.
Hurry, 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 hurry.
Look, you mean it's a job?
You play your cards right, no telling what it'll lead to.
Hurry, 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 hurry!
Look at him, folks. A delight for the young, a solace for the old. And for the price of one thin dime, you can take one home with you. Remove the wrapper, shake well, and don't forget to read the instructions on the back of each and every box. What am I saying? Hurry, 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 get your tickets right here. The show is going right on.
Hello, Mike.
Well, well. The great lady of the cinema. This is a privilege.
Don't kid me, Mike.
On the contrary. I frequently boast that I once had the honor of knowing you.
Mike, don't.
What are you doing down here? Slumming?
Well, Timmy told me you were here and I...
You were naturally curious. Well, I'm absorbing local color. You know me, a stickler for realism. Got a big part coming up on Broadway. Playing a carnival barker, sort of a Lillian. You don't believe me, do you?
Of course I do, Mike.
Since it got around that I taught the great Pearl White how to act, you'd be surprised how much I'm in demand. Look where it's got me.
You're still a sarcastic stinker, aren't you?
And you're still a rotten actress.
Oh, I know I am, Mike. I'm awful, and that's where you come in.
Me?
Yes. You see, if you could sort of be around me a lot, maybe be my leading man or something. I mean, you could help me.
Yes? Go on.
Oh, well, there's so much you could do for me, Mike. The films need you. I need you, Mike.
Are you by any chance suggesting that I act in these animated tintypes?
Oh, don't get sore,
Mike. Did I sacrifice all this?
But, Mike...
Did I permit myself to be sold by the yard like so much linoleum?
But, Mike, it pays $100 a week, and that's only a starter.
When do we start?
Oh, Mike!
Make this good. Wishes, everybody. Right. Camera. Action.
Look fear, Pearl. Look fear. All right, Timmy, the title. Where are the jewels? Tell them you know savvy, Pearl. You lotus blossom. Now grab her wig. Now, Timmy, sneer at her. All right, start choking her. Keep choking.
Come on, Mr. Farrington. Come on, Farrington.
Help!
Stop.
Cut. Now, now, now. Look, Farrington, all we got is a camera, see? It don't photograph no words. You gotta give it action. You gotta use your hands. You're acting like they was tied down. Here, let me show you. Stop! Unhand that woman, or I'll bust you in the kisser. See what I mean?
You don't need actors, you need acrobats.
What?
Oh, Mike! Mike! What he means is, you've got $1 million personality and a great physique, and the audience will want to see you use it. Won't they, boss?
Huh? Oh, sure. Why, when you come busting in through that door like a chunk of exploding dynamite, audiences are going to start cheering.
Sure they will.
Well, of course, if we're playing for homes for the feeble-minded, let's go.
Give it to him, Mike. Take it easy, will you?
Yeah, all right. We'll pick it up from where Timmy grabs Pearl. Feeble-minded, huh? Camera. Action! Come on, Mr. Farrington!
Stop! Unhand that woman!
Thank you.
swell, Mike. Great. If that don't murder him, I'll eat the fill him.
Oh, Mike, you were terrific.
Get me out of here. I resign. I quit.
A balloon. I wonder what genius thought this one up.
Who but McGuire?
Should have known. It's a natural conclusion for McGuire. He's full of hot air, too. Hey, would you mind leaving some slack so my blood can get around a little?
Why all the hush-hush, McGuire? Is this a state secret or something?
If we're going to make the afternoon edition, you better give us your story now.
You'll make it all right. You'll make it all over the front page. I ain't never let you down yet, have I?
Yeah.
Okay, then stick around a while.
We're all ready, Chief.
Just stick around.
Wonder what kind of a whoop-de-doo he's framing up now.
You two know the scene, don't you? It's when Timmy cuts the rope.
Yeah. Are you sure this thing's tied off good?
You're as safe as in your mother's arms. Ready, Timmy? We'll make it. Let it up to position. All set, boys?
All righty, boys.
We'll make it.
Look here. If anything happens to that girl, I'm going to run you through without even sharpening the point.
Now, Julie, now quit worrying, will you? I tell you, I got the thing anchored.
No.
That rope that Timmy's going to cut is only a prop. Now, quit worrying, will you?
It's all right.
Get set, everybody. Cameras. Action. Come on, Timmy. Get to that rope. Now broaden your sawing action. Now gnash your teeth. Gnash! Gnash! For the love of Pete, will you gnash? That's not gnashing. Cut. What's the matter with you?
I was gnashing.
You wasn't gnashing. You were chewing.
This is chewing. This is gnashing. Can't you tell the difference between when you see it?
Yeah, chew like a gnash and gnash like a chew.
I shall compromise. I shall spit.
All right, once again. Camera. Action. Come on, Timmy. Sneak up on it. Now, gnash! Pearl, Mike, you know you're gonna die, but you're smiling at death. Okay, Pearl, a little sad now. Turn your head to the man you love. Now, smile sadly. Swell, great. Okay, Timmy, cut the rope!
Help! Help! Let me down! Get me out of here! Help!
Let loose of that balloon!
Get me down! Get me out of here! Help! 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 Help!
Help! Help! Help! I quit! Pull that balloon! It's running away! Grab it!
Hey, how far is this contraption supposed to go up?
Oh, I don't know. About 30 feet, I guess.
And they're awful big feet.
Huh? Oh, well, I wouldn't worry. They've got a rope on us.
You mean this one?
Yeah, that's... Oh!
There's your story. Just like I promised. Pearl White and her leading man trapped in a runaway balloon. Is that a story?
Get going, Al.
Get her down! You murderous Irish bumhopper! Get her down!
She's all right, Julie. I tell you, she's all right. The balloon is right up there with her, hiding in the basket.
No, I ain't, Mr. McGuire. I'm here. I didn't get a chance to sneak in that basket like you said.
No, no, no.
Wait a minute. Don't hit me.
Pearl, Pearl, don't you know anything about balloons?
Only that they put something in them.
The way we're shooting up, it's probably full of some of your films.
Instead of being so funny, why don't you do something about it?
Me do something? You're the great serial queen, Fearless Fanny, the do-or-die gal. Why don't you do something?
I don't know anything about them.
Must be a valve or something. Maybe I could...
Don't shake the basket! What's the matter?
I don't feel so good.
Move over!
Of maybe 30 minutes, and I find myself worrying about keeping you dry.
That's the nicest worrying I've ever heard of.
No, no. Lightning is only electricity traveling through space. It creates a vacuum. Thunder is just the air rushing back into the vacuum. It can't hurt you.
Go on. Go on, keep talking. I like the way your voice sort of bubbles through your shirt. It makes me feel better.
You mean my heart's still there?
Mm-hmm.
Good. I thought maybe it was still in my boots.
Mike.
Yeah?
I'm not scared anymore.
That's fine.
I'm all sort of relaxed and drowsy. Is that bad?
Probably the altitude.
Mike, pull me closer.
Better?
Oh, swell.
Oh, this is ridiculous. In a play, this would call for magnificent speeches. I want to say a lot of things. I can't seem to find the words.
Mike, it doesn't take a lot of big words. Just a few little ones will do it. Mike, will you say, Pearl, I love you? Oh, millions of times I've wondered how it'd be. You just said it. Will you say it, Mike? I mean, even if it's just in fun.
I love you, Pearl.
That didn't sound like just for fun.
It wasn't. Something I've been trying not to say for a long, long time.
Oh, Mike.
Is not only going to be beautiful, but big. And remember, it's 2 weeks from today, and you're all invited. Got your nice choice seats right up in front. Compliments of the studio. And oh, yeah. The 8 Callahan boys are going to give out with O'Connor's speed. backed up by a 60-piece symphony orchestra.
Hold it!
And get this. We're given the honor of performing the wedding ceremony to His Honor the Mayor. Not bad, huh?
Where did you first meet your fiancé, Miss White?
Oh, it was a long time ago in Danbury, Connecticut.
He did her out of $98.
Nobody paid it back.
I'm ready for Miss White. Over here by the flowers, please.
Where's Mike?
Mike? Farrington! Hey, Farrington!
Here he is.
Okay, Farrington, come on. We're ready for you. Snap it up. All right, over here by the flowers. No, no, no. Put your arm around it. Come on, turn your head. Give him a smile. Give him a load of that personality. All right, boys, shoot.
Hold it.
Now, one with Pearl and me in my office, making the arrangements for the honeymoon.
Come on, Mike.
You got plenty of time to see him.
Where are they going on their honeymoon?
We got a location department working on that now. Some of my boys suggested they get married in a balloon, like where he proposed to her. But I slapped them down, boy. We gotta have dignity. A marriage ain't no honky-tonk show. I'm thinking about getting a special train and send them on a tour of the country. Give the folks a chance to see it. You can do a stunt in every town. If things got so many possibilities, I get a headache thinking about it.
Hey, wait a minute, that's me.
Bet. All right, now, come on, get close together.
Keep it quiet, will you, fellas?
All right, hurry up, hurry up.
Holy smoke, I'll be right down.
What is it?
The president is calling a special session of Congress to declare war on Germany.
Oh! Hey, wait a minute, boys, wait a minute. You ain't heard the rest of the plan. We're going to have a reception right... How do you like that? Everything happens to me. War. They couldn't hold off till after the wedding. No, they got to do it now and gum up everything.
War. Well, that's horrible.
You said it. Now we got to rewrite the last six episodes. Hey, where are them writers?
Mike.
We got to write the war in. Battle, cannons, warships. Where are them guys?
I'll get them.
Looking on the job. Don't they know there's a war going on?
What's the matter, Mike?
Nobody talks here. Nobody's supposed to even think here. Step right up, ladies and gentlemen. Step right up and have your talking and thinking done for you while you wait. No more problems to decide. It's all done for you. Cost you nothing but your self-respect.
Hey, you sound like you've been hoisting one too many, Mike.
Perhaps. Just trying to keep up the illusion that I'm a man.
Mike, no man has to do what he doesn't want to do.
Mr. Timmons, in your unparalleled wisdom, you have uttered a truism. No man has to do what he doesn't want to do. But you've left no room for the half-man, half-slave.
I don't get it. You love her, don't you?
Of course. That's not enough.
Look, you're doing all right for yourself. A lot better than those one-night stands.
Is it? I wonder.
So, what's the answer?
There's only one answer.
Am I breaking in on something?
No. See you later.
What's this all about?
Just the turning of a worm. No, I take that back. Not even a worm. I've lost my identity. A nothing. A zero minus.
Oh, Mike, you're still head man with me. What's wrong with the woman helping the man she loves?
Nothing. Nothing at all. In this case, it's a fine business arrangement. I get paid for every kiss, with time and a half for overtime.
Mike, you're drunk.
Confidentially, I'm cockeyed. This business will get anybody that way.
Mike, what are you talking about?
Look, the only reason I got into this lunacy was to help you. I felt I could build you up. Make you play a scene without looking like something on a wire. Built you up. You dragged me down to where you are.
Dragged you down? Why, you cheap, insufferable, conceited snob. Dragged you down. I'll fix that. Mike. Mike, why are you doing this? You must have a reason. I believe you're doing it to get out of marrying me. That's why, isn't it? Answer me, isn't it?
I'm sorry, Pearl.
Oh, but Mike, you can't stop loving me like that. You said you loved me and you meant it. I know you did. You can't stop just like turning off the gas or something.
Let's just say I'm a four-flushing ham, as you once described me, and let it go at that.
All right, Mike. I guess if a man feels that way, a girl'd be a fool to try and hold him. Maybe someday you'll change your mind, but it'll be too late. So run along, Mr. Farrington. It hasn't been fun.
Pearl.
Get out!
That's fine. That gets her started. Let's go, Pearl. Take five. Remember, folks, 50,000 gets it to the top.
Now, who's going to get it?
1,000. 1,000. Take one, Pearl. Remember, 50,000.
Three.
3,000. Take three, Pearl. Step right up here and fill out the application. Well, that's it.
In the army, we'd all be home in a week.
Hey, you look like that guy on the screen. Are you an actor?
Actor. Round like an orange.
Hey, gang, here's that Hugo Mortimer.
Well, what do you know, you bad boy?
I just get the war going good, and now they call it off. Get the rioters. We got to write the war out. Come on,
right.
Get them. Go on.
Once you said to me, what a man can grasp in his hand, he cannot keep. Only what he has in his heart can he hold on to. I had everything. Worldly goods, enough to hold my friends and to confound my enemies. I had power enough to determine who should be struck from my list and who should remain. I struck them off, one by one, till there were no more, and I was alone. And I found that I'd struck off no one but myself.
No man is completely alone, unless he wants it that way.
Wasn't it Chopin you were so fond of, my dear? Do sit down and make yourself comfortable for a while. A long, long while.
Harrington!
Michael Farrington!
what if they are laughing at cereals? They gotta buy tickets to do that, don't they?
Pearl White is through.
Through? Not while I got a few bucks, she ain't. I'll up the advertising budget.
But the audiences don't want cereals anymore.
They're growing up. Moving pictures got to grow up with them.
Growing up? Ain't I growed up? But I'm still a little boy at heart. Same with audiences. You just ain't doing a good selling job.
We're losing money on them.
Excuse me. A wireless for you, Miss McGuire. I thought it might be important.
How would you know what bad business is? You put up four walls with seats in it. I feed you to fill them, and all of a sudden you're a bunch of geniuses.
Jake.
Boys, maybe I am being a little too tough about this. I realize you have your troubles. Who hasn't? And old friends, you gotta stick together. Tell you what I'll do. I'll send Pearl on a little vacation. Cancel this cereal, and you boys can have the Western.
Now you're talking sense.
Well, I take back everything I was thinking about you.
You'll never regret this, Mac.
We gotta eat, don't we? Yeah? Who? Farrington. I'll see him in a minute. All right, run along, you thieves, so you can keep your eye on your cashiers.
Gonna be a bigger and better year, man.
We'll make you a rich man in spite of yourself.
And don't forget the contract.
You know me, my word is my bonus. Come on in.
Hello, Mac.
Well, well, the talk of Broadway, and here in poor little me's office, and after so many years. What did you come for, to read me your reviews?
Where's Pearl?
Oh, you want to read her the reviews.
I went to her hotel, she's checked out. Where is she?
Ain't you hurt her enough?
Yes.
So you agree with me, you heel. Go on, I'm a busy man. Get going, will you?
Mac, if you don't tell me where she is, I'm gonna do something that you won't think is funny.
Such as what?
Such as punch you right in the nose.
Oh, now, wait a minute, wait a minute. What's it to you? What do you want to know where she is for?
I happen to love her.
Oh, well. Here. Gonna drop everything and rush right over after her?
I can't. Not till the show closes.
I never thought I'd live to see the day when I, a motion picture producer, would be grateful to a Broadway competitor. I hope the play runs forever. Gonna punch me in the nose.
Said a word in 30 seconds. What's wrong, Julia?
Just sitting here, thinking of a great, big, beautiful man.
Why, Julia?
Just happened to be reading Variety. Just happened to come across a little item saying Mike Farrington's play had closed after a very successful run. Just happened.
It just happens. I read Variety, too, and I'm not interested.
Does it also happen you received a wireless from his boat? What do you know? It's addressed to you. Says he'll be here tomorrow night. He wants to make you a little speech. He's been rehearsing.
What am I supposed to do now? Holler for the smelling salts?
Miss White, on stage, please.
All right.
Why don't you stop kidding yourself, child?
That's just what I am doing. Does he think he can cuff me out of his way anytime he pleases, and when he whistles, I'll come running? No, thanks. I don't want any more.
Might you quote that in the wire?
In full. And don't try to cut it down to 10 words.
Oh.
clumsy postal card. Someone had forgotten how you say to mail. Seems as though some tourist had meant for it to reach her dad. For it all's a typical tale. Naturally, I read what she wrote. This is what she said, and I quote, I came to Paris to buy me a gown. To Paris, and oh, what a town! The lights were shining, the music was gay. I bought me my gown and decided to stay. Now, Papa, don't preach to me, preach to me. Papa, don't preach to me. Let my heart break while it's young. Now, Papa, don't preach to me, preach to me. Papa, don't preach to me. Let me fling till my fling is all flung. I don't see Paris, not snowed with Pierre. That X marks my room, but I'm seldom up there. I stroll through Paris today with Maurice. The Rue de la Paix means the street of the peace. Now, Papa, don't preach to me, preach to me. Papa, don't preach to me. Let my heart break, if it must.
And it must.
Now, Papa, don't preach to me, preach to me. Papa, don't preach to me. And don't cut off my guarantee card. My gown got all worn up, but I'm still okay.
You're made for Paris.
I'm finding that out. I still have no past, but my future's in doubt. Now, Papa, don't preach to me, preach to me. Papa, don't preach to me. Let my heart break, let it roam.
Let it roam.
Now, Papa, don't preach to me, preach to me. Papa, don't preach to me.
Or I'll never, no, never, no, preach to me,
preach to me.
Or I'll never, no, never come home. Papa.
Papa, don't preach, Papa, don't preach, Papa, don't preach to me.
Or I'll never, no, never come
sent that wire yet?
Not yet.
Don't! Send this one instead. I will meet you at the depot. That's only seven words. I'll tell him the other three when he gets here.
Oh, don't!
I do. I'm so happy.
Have you quite finished with the stage, Miss White? Is it all right for me to go on now?
It's all yours, Mr. Timmons.
Thank you.
Go on, get it over.
Will I give him a stunt tonight? I feel as if I had wings. You took so many x-rays last night. You must know something. I've got to know now. I can take it. How bad is it?
We have agreed that with surgery, then therapy, you may in all likelihood walk again.
May? When?
For
injured nerves heal slowly.
When?
Might take 1 or 2 years.
But even after that, you couldn't be sure.
Oh, Miss White, you mustn't be discouraged. You know, we doctors always look on the worst side of things. We will be able to tell much more about after the operation.
Thank you. I understand.
I'll make all the necessary preparations.
Oh, wait a minute. I can't go now. Not until tonight. I have a date.
Miss White, this has to be done at once.
I'm sorry. It must wait. It's only for a little while. I have to meet someone.
If you do, we won't be responsible, Miss White.
Julia, call the beauty shop. I want my hair done and a facial and a manicure.
It's madness.
Pearl, please. The doctors know what's best.
Do they, Timmy? I never went to medical school, but I'll bet all they ever taught them about the heart was that it pumps blood. Right?
Miss Gibbs, we forbid it. She's taking a terrible risk.
She's done that all her life. Neither you nor anyone else can change it. You, being French, should understand.
Please.
Well, have her at the hospital as soon as you can this evening.
Thank you, Doctor. I know what you have in mind, Pearl. It's completely stupid. It wouldn't make any difference to Mike.
I don't intend to let it make any difference. Timmy, when it's time, will you come and carry me down to the car?
You've carried me for years. That's the least I can do.
Come on, Julia. Start making me pretty. I've got a date with a man. Wonderful seeing you again, Mike. We've been following your career in Variety. We all think you're pretty wonderful.
Pearl, a long time ago, Julia told me that someday I'd learn to beg. That's why I came over. Will you marry me? Come back to America?
Back to America? Oh, Mike, I couldn't. I belong here. This is my town. Why, every time one of these Frenchmen holler bravo, I want to jump right over the footlights and kiss them. I love it. No, Mike, I couldn't give it up.
Then you don't have to. I'll stay here. All I want is you.
You know, Mike, I've waited for this day. The night you walked out on me, I began to make up things I'd say if this moment ever arrived. Each day, I'd add something new. Something a little more violent. You don't know what it does to a girl to be jilted, Mike. Here you are. Nothing. I'm not angry. I'm not anything. It just isn't important to me.
What do you mean?
I mean, Mike, I don't love you anymore. Oh, I knew I had to get over you. You taught me how to be a perfectionist, remember, Mike? Well, I'm afraid it's perfectly complete. And now let's forget about it. You're in Paris, one of the gayest cities in the world. And there's no reason on earth why we can't have a wonderful time together.
No, thanks. There's been a sudden change in my plans, and I'd like to get home. Do you mind dropping me off here?
Pierre, pull over to the curb. No hard feelings, Mike.
Of course not. It's all been very lovely, as well as educational, Miss White.
Mike. Quickly. Get in.
Sorry you couldn't catch the act, Timmy. First time in my life I give a good performance and nobody's around to see it. I had just the right shading. Pierre, stop the car. Stop here. Timmy, look. Timmy, carry me in. I want to see it.
But Pearl, the doctors are waiting.
Please, Timmy, a few more minutes won't make any difference.
Improved a bit.
I guess I'll never learn.